Alright, dickheads, I'm your chunky messiah, Ethan, and I'm just here with some more of this here Nioh on that there PC. And it's been a couple of days, because I had to go to work. I swear to God, it always feels like whenever I go to work, it feels like I've had like a mini, like a mini school holiday, because I'm gone for basically a week, and then I show back up again. It's a wild one. It's a wild one, that one. It's a bit of a wild one. Anyway, yes, here with some more Nioh. I'm trying to remember what I was doing. I should honestly check. If I recall correctly... Yep, I remember now. I had decided not to do the remainder of this level in that last episode because of the boss fight that's gonna kick my ass. However, let's just avoid that boss fight for now. Let's do a bit of an explore, do a bit of a wander. Let me guess, cut down by Yokai. Cut down by Yokai. Oh, that's a big lad. Oh, hello. No, I don't want to talk to you. I see. You're the distraction, big lad. He's not, he is actually, he's a problem. Big angry, only looking lad. Throws rocks at you if you're not careful, I believe. And can do a lot of damage if you also aren't careful. Unfortunately for him, I more or less remember how to fight those guys, because there's a couple of them in this level. I think there's also in a Twilight Mission version of this, there might, or a secondary mission. Not the basic version of this map. I think there might be a Kappa down here. Something full of loot. Anyway, there's something that runs around that's full of loot, and I'm pretty sure the only one, I think the only enemy in the game that can match that specific description is a good old Kappa. Hello, man. Hello. How's it? Okay, this is. I need to not be cocky. Because when I get cocky, I also get dead. The two are essentially the exact same situation for me. The precise, exact, immediate, exact... I said exact twice, it's fine. I want it to be exactly exact. But yeah, it's the exact same scenario. It's the exact same situation. One has never occurred without the other. You cannot die, this is true. This is a true fact. You cannot die unless you're arrogant. The only thing in the world that's actually fatal is hubris, turns out. I know, it took me by surprise as well. Oh, fuck. Okay. Alright, I was like gearing up for an actual fight. I wasn't expecting to behead him in one hit. Alright. Hello, big boy! And, yep, that's what'll happen if you, again. Ah, full of hubris. When fighting this thick lad. He will completely destroy you, because despite how dumb he looks with his tongue hanging out of his mouth and the one big boggle eye, that thick boy is a strong boy. He's a dangerous but oh good, it's another thick boy. I am terrified of the day, the inevitable day, when people will have, essentially stopped using the word thick in a comedic sense, and I will still be saying it, and it'll make me sound incredibly old. Ah, we poisoned him, I think. Is that poison? Well, I don't know. Whatever it was purple, and he didn't seem to like it. Bizodenodachi. A purple Bizodenodachi. What the fuck's a Bizodenodachi? Is that just the standard Adachi but fancy? Yeah, that looks like that is in fact exactly what that is. Oh no. Oh no, we're max familiarity. Guess we got the lightning one then. Oh dear, okay. We are approaching the boss room, and I'm not thrilled. damn it, we still can't weather warrior the West choose. I'm not thrilled. Because we are just going to eat shit. This one boss fight is the only reason why I bring the antitoxin pills. This one fight, genuinely. Yeah, we got a lot of cocoons up there. One of which, at least, is very obviously a human. The others, you could argue, but there was that one in the fucking fetal position, which basically made it impossible to argue whether or not that one's human. Some poor lad hung upside down and drained of his vital fluids. Yep. I was a bit busy looking at the corpse to notice the woman all over a different corpse. Good, yep, grody black tongue and creepy teeth and eyes. Good, okay. It's official, it's a monster, we can kill it. And dead. It just occurred to me, is it toxin that I need to be worried about with her, or is it paralysis? I think it's both. Because I believe that, if I recall correctly, which I may not, I think that her... I think that her umbrella does paralysis damage. Or does, inflicts paralysis while her, while she throws needles that do, poison. We're basically gonna be fighting her a lot. Thankfully, there is not much of a wait in between fights. Just a little bit of loading. Oh, wait, shit. Hi, Aiden. Ah, yeah, that's what does it. Sorry, I'm not going to be able to talk during this, because I'm going to be a bit busy just, like, focusing. Ow. And I'm paralyzed, which means I'm definitely dead. Yep, okay. This boss fight, you know how in Dark Souls, in the Souls games, there's always basically one fight, one boss, one enemy, past a certain point where you can basically, more or less anyone can get through certain, like the earliest stages of a Souls game correctly. Basically anyone can. But then there is always a certain point, a certain encounter that's, you know, welcome to the real Dark Souls, I believe is the phrase. This bitch is welcome to the real fucking Nioh. This enemy is the one where the game suddenly decides, you know what, we're not fucking around anymore. There's bosses after her who are a lot easier. Okay, I've misjudged that. And I'm paralyzed. Oh, God, how did that not hit me? Yeah, that grab's not a great thing to be got by, either. I'm noticing she's not actually doing her, she's not actually, as of yet, made any attempt to throw her needles. I'm worried now I'm misremembering that she throws needles, and that she actually doesn't. Yeah, because so far all she's doing is hurling that shit at us. And I'm paralyzed. Alright. Thank you. I really badly want to just go fucking rage mode. Ah, yeah, there's the needles. Okay. Okay, Ethan, don't get greedy. Fuck it. To get the last few hits, I will go rage mode. Okay. Just because I could, I could feel that it, I felt like I was about to die. Okay. That only took 5 minutes. Must be better at this than I thought. Probably not. Probably bald luck. Oh, it's probably just that every other time I've played it, I've just had literally zero patience, literally zero chill about fighting it. I mean, presumably you had to face several yokai to get in here. Oh, I think this is our first guardian. I don't know if we unlocked this guardian spirit at the moment. Yeah, we do. Yeah, it ran straight at us. I think we just got his guardian spirit. You can tell it's bad when dogs are eating people. You know what? I said that as a joke. That's actually fair. When there's wild dogs eating people, that's probably not a good sign. You know, this talk of the Sengoku Jidai's political situation is really... it really makes me annoyed that Samurai Warriors 4 Empires isn't on PC. Because that's probably my favorite, like, of the Warriors Empires games. Because they never made a Warriors Orochi Empires. Kill for that, that'd be gold. That'd sell like hotcakes. I don't know what a hotcake is. I assume it's just a hot cake. Possessed by Fuse Ushi? Gonna say it's Fuse Ushi. Via Spirit Division. Not quite sure what that means, but yes, we got our first unlockable guardian spirit. I remember, is William just... Yep, William's just dressed in his armor. No one even lent him a robe or whatever to wear. We have a guest. A dirty, hairy guest. Like, he's not even at a bath! Ooh, hello, pretty dragon.
I don't have time for this.
Calm down. Everything has been taken care of.
I've never understood this bit where fucking William looks surprised that Hanzo's the- Oh, good. Okay, that ghost cat, best character in the game. Just saying, just calling it now. That ghost cat is by far the best character in this fucking game. I don't like people having frivolity and fun. I think the implication there is that Kanbe basically tried to blame his son's disappearance on the enemy faction to justify going to war with them or something. I don't know. Oh god, a woman. I don't know what. A woman. What? Woman in Japan?
Who are you?
I dislike the company of drunk samurai.
Hey! I am no samurai.
No, it isn't. Yeah, I was gonna say. He doesn't argue he's not drunk, he just says I'm not a samurai, which clearly isn't the problem in what you said. It's one of them, but there's two issues she has with the people fitting that description, and one of them's clearly greater than the other one. Know what I mean? Okay, lovely. Deep in the shadows. Sir William, I can't thank you enough for saving Nagamasa. You have my utmost gratitude. That said, though, my fellow countrymen and I have some familiarity. Though my fellow countrymen and I have some familiarity with foreign names, I'm afraid I cannot help but find yours difficult to pronounce. Might I suggest calling yourself Anjin from now on? It means pilot in Japanese, fitting for a seafarer such as yourself. I'm sure it would be easier for those of this land to understand. Yeah, probably, you know, for a country that doesn't really... For a country whose language doesn't have a great time differentiating between R and L sounds, which isn't racist, by the way, that is actually just a fact. I can't remember why, but there's something about the Japanese language which means that I think R and L sounds may or may not. I think they might just be interchangeable in that language, or one exists but the other doesn't. I can't remember which way, like, what it is, but there is a linguistic reason for the mixing up of L's and R's when speaking English. So, giving him a name, William, probably isn't the best one, is my point. There we are. Twilight mission in Ominous Cavern. We've also unlocked Finders Keepers. Gesture Prostate. No, Prostrate, fair enough. You got another mission over here, Wreathed in Flame. Ah, that's where that area's set lit on fire. And we got the Spirit Stone Slumbers, Finders Keepers. What we got for Twilight missions? An Ominous Cavern. Yep. Where dark forces gather. Yep, a lot too frightening. What do I want to do? You know what? I think we'll do Finders Keepers. Just because... it's not a particularly long mission, if I recall correctly. Sir Anjin, I have a sir. He's not a knight. And samurai wouldn't call each other sir. Fucking, no. I have a rather embarrassing request. The famed sword... Fuck me. Heshikiri Hasebe? Heshikiri Hasebe? Hasebe? I don't know. That one, treasure of the Kuroda clan, has gone missing. I recall feeling a fumbling at my waist while I was grappling with that demonic harlot in the cave. But she didn't have it. There's been some other demon. I beg of you, please find the sword and return it to me. Certainly. What are friends for? What are friends for? But the reclaiming of lost objects. I don't know why I'm talking like a fucking rube. I don't know why I said rube. I meant idiot. Rube? Rube? The fuck's that? What is that? What is happening to me? Oh. Right, well, I've got a fucking solid guess as to who has your sword there, mate. Because I can see a capper. What's this? Thick lad? Yep, thick lad. Hey! Come on! Ah, there was a rock in the way. I thought I'd just gone mad. Lovely, good lad. He gave it a go. Now, where's that fucking capper? Yeah, Kappa, 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 Kappa. Yeah, Kappa, 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 Kappa. Oh, It's making music like something just woke up. Oh no, 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 no. They are not getting my butt sphere. Oh, God. Come on. Slow down. Why are you dickheads protecting the Kappa? It's got treasures. It's got treasures that I could have shared with you. I mean, I wouldn't have, but I could have. Yeah, you know what? I'm just gonna fire sword this little bastard. Wow, that was really it. It really was just kill the Kappa. I was expecting something a bit more elaborate, I'm gonna be honest with you. Like anything. Anything more elaborate than that. But I guess I don't deserve such things. Oh, we got a new gesture, some weapons, and the ability to, I believe, essentially literally make the set of armor he's wearing, which is a nice set, so I might see if we can make that, actually, just so we can transmog into it. Yes, that's the sword, all right. The treasure of the Kuroda, bestowed upon my father by Lord Nobunaga himself. How could I ever face my father again if I'd lost it? My deepest gratitude, Sir Anjin. And, don't tell my dad. Oh. We have another mission there. Okay. Well, let's just quickly go to the blacksmith. See if we can make that. Forge. Hand over the smithing text. Yes. Yes, I did. Right. Oh, Hank. We need hanks of yokai hair. We got loads of everything else, but we just need hanks of yokai hair. Do you have hanks of yokai hair? Looking like new. Looking like solid new. Solid new there. And I'm guessing I can't just. Guessing I can't just because I have the thing. Yeah, I can't just wear it. No, no. Fair enough. Fair enough. Right. I'm trying to decide whether or not I want the, whether or not I want that Guardian Spirit. Yeah, I want the Guardian Spirit. All right. Sir Anjin, could I ask you to search for the sword? I just did that. Treasure of our clan. I'd entrusted it to that oaf Nagamasa, but he just came to me wailing that he'd lost it again. Fuck me, running. I believe you already found it from once. The football dropped it in the cave during that fight with the Yoko. I would ask you to come to the clan's aid. Around the time the sword lost, dead warriors began wandering the cave. Okay, great. So, this is that same level, but full of skeleton boys? Full of bone boys? So, you could say, sorry if you could hear the chair squeaking. You could say that we're gonna go to the bone zone, but you could also be, you know, a reasonable man and not really do that particular goof. How long is this? You know what? I think this is gonna have to be something for the next episode, because I need to record 3 episodes today, so I can't just be spending time making one episode really long. So, yeah. Bye. Well, I hope you enjoyed that. I might not have, but then that's kind of irrelevant. I'd make the stuff, not watch it. Anyway, big thanks to the names that are and have been scrolling across the screen. Their donations to my Patreon campaign are a huge help to me and the channel. If you'd also like to have your name listed here, follow the link in the description to find my Patreon page. There are rewards and such. Down there you'll also find links to my Twitter, Twitch, and the channel's Discord server. Stuff often occurs in one or indeed all of those places, so go have a look. And if you want more content, I upload basically a video a day. Right, I'm out of time. Bye.